I'm really missing those extended weekends once per month when I was here in Belgrade. And I'll be very honest to you and prove that MBA makes you smarter is that this time I booked my hotel nearby Skardarlia because I knew that when I see my friends, it's going to take a long evening. Actually, it was a very short morning, to be honest. I'm not going to talk to you about the company, what we do. You can find that on our websites. But I'm going to share with you my personal thoughts and my something that put me into MBA and the experience that I got after that. So just shortly about me, I started my career in Alcatel. At that time, it was a huge company, one of the largest telecommunication companies in the world. Nowadays, you know, I guess, what's happening. It means that life changes. Education, I'm a diploma engineer of electronics and telecommunication, and I completed my executive MBA some five years ago already. In the meantime, I was with the vice chairman for Eastern Europe region. It's the largest ICT organization in the world with its seat in the United Nations. With president of Macedonian ICT Chamber of Commerce, Alumni Club president, Rotary Club Skopje, this year president for Rotary. It's also part of the life. You have to dedicate a part of yourself, not only to yourself, to the community, to the company, but to the community as well, not only to yourself and family and the company, of course. And some awards. Why MBA or executive MBA? Because believe me, I met a lot of very good guys, very good friends. Some of them became of my great friends. The proof of that is last evening, actually morning. And some of them are definitely going to become, or even are now, great leaders. Not only their companies, but I guess worldwide. What put me actually in the MBA? I started my own company when everybody was leaving the country. I decided something. Everybody thought that I was got nuts. I don't know. I got stupid or I was crazy. But I decided to stay in the country, in Macedonia, and to try to do something by myself. In the meantime, I started my own company. Nowadays, it's a company I remember when we started in less than 10 square meters. It was me and my personal assistant. At that time, she's still with me in the company. And nowadays, capital is something like 65 plus. I can't remember even. I remember when a friend of mine told me once, when you're entering the company and some of the people say good morning and you have no idea who that is, who that person is, and later on you realize that it's your own employee, then you have a problem. That's why from recently I started with something. I moved from HR to human capital. Actually, I'll try to explain later what is the difference and how I find it. And so I found so many answers on that many questions that I had during the running of my company. So somehow, my advice to MBA and to executive MBA is a role with MBA for sure, but try to make sure that you have at least 2 years experience. Because if you don't have experience, if you go directly from the faculty, from the university, to MBA, you're not going to learn more. You're going to learn more, of course, but it's not going to be the same effect. Try at least to have a couple of years experience. For executive MBA, stands the same, but you need to have at least managerial experience. So finally, I had managed to replace taking decisions based on my sixth sense. What does it mean? It means that actually everything was written. Then you find that you got so many answers on so many questions that you have, and you relied on your sixth sense. Sixth sense is important, but sometimes it could lead in a very wrong direction. So I found those answers during my MBA studies. And I'm sure that once you're old, you'll be looking forward, just like I'm missing those extended weekends for myself. And this is also very important for me. It was really the place where the theory meets practice. I had some very, not all the professors are the same, but it was very good that they had the practice, actually professional. My personal advice, surround yourself by people you can learn from. Pay attention to details, but not bother yourself with small things. Keep remember that. Dream huge to make it big. And running a company just like a sailing race. Does anybody has any experience with sailing? But not only for fun, racing as well. It's a little bit difference. What does it make so important? Because you have to find people that will stay on a very small area, because each and every of that person is a story for itself. So you have to, everybody needs to cook, everybody needs to clean, or at least you need to dedicate a portion of that job to anybody on the ship. It's a little bit longer story, but I'm not going to take too much time. If anybody's interested, I'm here. So the last thing, which is very important, is remember one thing. Now we are coming to human resource, to human capital. We know that resources are something that you use to produce and it's gone. But capital is something that you make something more from something you have. That's why I would rather prefer to say for human capital development rather than HR. It's something that I learned from my MBA studies. And remember one thing, that everything you have in your own company, everything, is just a matter of or subject of depreciation. Only people that you have in your company are a matter of appreciation. Of course, if you treat them well and if you invest in them. That's shortly from my side. Thank you.